Hello friends, welcome to this channel, Fundamentals of Engineering. Subscribe this channel to explore engineering knowledge. In this lecture, today we are going to see new topic regarding the lecture series of Theory of Metal Cutting, Part 10. We are going to discuss heat generation in metal cutting process. How the heat generation is taking place whenever there is a contact between workpiece and tool, while the chip formation due to that, where are the different heat zones are taking place, that we are going to discuss in this lecture. If you miss the earlier parts regarding Theory of Metal Cutting lecture series, the link available in the description box, you can check the link and can see remaining parts if you have missed. Now we are discussing the heat generation in metal cutting. So whenever we are doing the machining operation, the power or the total energy given by an external source for cutting is spent in the form of shear energy, frictional energy and momentum energy. So now consider we are having this as a workpiece, and when we apply the force by using this cutting tool, at the shear plane, the shear energy, frictional energy and momentum energy will be taking place, and due to that we are getting the chip which are flowing on the rake surface, of the tool. So this is the chip moving along the rake surface. So this is our original surface. And when we remove the chip, we are getting this finished surface. By the application of tool. So, in practice, the momentum energy per unit volume is negligible as compared to the other energies, which are shear energy and frictional energy. Hence, for all practical purposes, when we are doing the metal cutting operations, it can be assumed that the energy consumed in a plastic deformation, to which we are getting here, this is the plastic deformation at the shear plane, it consumes the friction between the chip and the tool face, where we are getting three heat zones, which is shear zone, friction zone and tool work interface. So what is that we are going to see. So first, the shear zone we are getting at the shear plane. So this is our shear plane. At this shear plane, the maximum force is applied, and due to that maximum force, the shearing and cracking will be takes place and the chips are formed. So we are getting here, this is our shear zone. So at this shear zone, the maximum heat is generated due to plastic deformation of the material. As we have seen, the plastic deformation is taking place, means at this plane, the deformation of the workpiece is taking place and chip is formed. So at this shear zone, we are getting the maximum heat. So the major heat which is generated in this zone is carried away by this chip, and remaining a smaller amount is carried away by the workpiece. So we are getting the three heat zones. First one we can call it as a primary heat zone or shear zone. Here the maximum heat will be carried away by maximum heat carried away by chip and small amount of heat carried away by workpiece. So here we are getting at the shear zone, maximum heat is carried away by the moving chip and small amount is transferred to the workpiece. So the total heat generated in shear zone consists of heat of deformation and heat of distortion. Next zone we are getting, that is a friction zone. Where it is called as secondary heat zone, which we are getting whenever the chip is moving along the rake face of the tool. At that point the friction is taking place, and due to that friction we are getting this secondary heat zone, which is nothing but friction zone. So in this, the chips move upwards along the tool rake face, and good amount of heat energy is generated due to the friction which we are getting in the contact between chip and tool surface, and which further rises the temperature in the chip. So here some amount of or maximum amount which is generated, the maximum heat carried away by chip and small amount of heat carried away by cutting tool. As the chip is moving along the rake face of the tool, so maximum it is carried away by the chip and small amount of heat is carried away by the tool. Then we are getting third heat zone, which is nothing but the interface we are getting at the work and tool. Interface at the work and tool. So this heat zone we are getting here. So this work and heat zone here, due to friction between work and tool, the heat which is generated, this heat is carried away partly by the tool and partly by the workpiece. So we are getting some heat carried away by workpiece and some heat is carried away by tool. So we are getting three heat zones. First one is a shear zone, second which is red in color, that is nothing but friction zone, where the chip is moving along the rake face of the tool, we are getting this friction zone. And third, we are getting heat zones at work and tool interface, which is shown by using this color. So this is our third heat zone, work and tool interface. So if you have seen three heat zones, maximum heat is carried away by the chip and maximum heat will be generated at this shear zone. Maximum heat is carried away by the chip, maximum heat is generated by the shear zone, then friction zone, and lastly work and tool interface. So we are getting the heat zones at the shear zone. We are getting 60 to 65% of heat will be generated among the total heat which is generated. Then at the friction zone we are getting 30 to 35% of heat will be generated, and next work tool interface we are getting 5 to 10% of heat will be generated. So among all the 100% of the heat, maximum heat will be generated by the shear zone. Next, heat will be generated at the friction zone, and third, heat generated at the work and tool interface. So if you have seen heat distribution between chip, work and tool, here at the chip is carrying away maximum heat. So 70% of heat we are getting at the chip, the distribution which is generated. Then work, we are getting the tool, which is 20%. Sorry, tool it is 5%. And work will be 20%. So the maximum heat distribution will be at chip, then work, then tool. So if you are seeing, in the heat generated during the machining operation, the maximum heat is carried away by the chip, small amount of heat is carried by the work and tool. So as the chip is flowing from the tool work interface, so whatever the heat which will be generated, that is again taken away by the chip. So we have to see, whatever the heat which is generated during the machining operation, that heat is carried by the maximum amount is carried by the chip, then work, and then lastly tool. So we have to see how much will be the temperature rise in the chip. So if you know the temperature rise in the chip, means heat generated in the chip, based on that we will select the tool material which is greater hot hardness temperature than the temperature induced in the machining. If possible, we can select the cutting fluid so that we can overcome the temperature which is generated. If it is not possible, then we can adjust the process parameters. We can adjust the process parameter. So the heat generated can be given by heat carried away by the chip and heat carried away by work. Carried by chip plus heat carried away by work. Small amount of heat is carried away by the tool, so it is neglected. So we are considering only the heat carried away by the chip and heat carried away by work. So the heat carried away by the chip can be given as m dot Cp delta T. So we can plus heat carried away by the work can be given as Aw. A is the fraction of the heat which is carried away by the work, and the heat generated we are having, that is capital W. So we can write here m dot Cp delta T is equal to W minus Aw, where W is the total heat generated and A into W is the heat carried away by the work. So the A is the fraction of the heat is carried away by the work. It is a 10 to 20% value. So this m dot we can write, that is density into volume. Density into volume into Cp. Delta T is the rise in temperature. We can write here W 1 minus A. So this volume we can write width into T1 into Vc, that is the initial volume, into density into Cp. Delta T is equal to W 1 minus A. So the delta T we can write W 1 minus A upon dividing this whole value B into T1 initial chip thickness into VC into density into CP. So this W we can write FC into VC, that is a work done, into 1 minus A upon B into T1 into VC into density into CP. So this VC and this VC will be cancelled, cutting velocity. So we are getting the rise in temperature of chip, which is delta T. Rise in temperature of chip, which is delta T, we can get here is equal to cutting force into 1 minus A upon B into T1 into density into CP. So we are getting the rise in temperature of the chip, that is FC into 1 minus A, B into T1 into rho, that is density into CP. So by using this rise in temperature, we can decide whether to use cutting fluid or not. If possible cutting fluid, then we can use the cutting fluid. If cutting fluid is not possible, then we can adjust the process parameters. So that whatever the rise in temperature we are getting in the chip, that should be as low as possible than the temperature which is induced in the machining, so that the hot hardness temperature will not be too low. Hot hardness temperature will not be greater than the temperature which is induced, so that the strength of the tool can be weakened out. So we have to select based on this rise in temperature either cutting fluid. If the cutting fluid is not possible, then we can adjust the process parameters, and this rise in temperature we can measure by using the tool work thermocouple or pyrometer or calorimetric setup. So by using that we can check whatever the rise in temperature we are getting. Hope you understood whatever the heat generation we are getting in the metal cutting operation. If you like it, please stay connected and don't forget to subscribe the channel. Thank you. Thank you very much.